In part one of this two-part screencast, we're going to build a call center with TaskRouter and Twilio functions. If you want to follow along, there's a GitHub link down in the description, as well as appearing in the card in the upper right now. For our call center, a business event will be an incoming call. Our application will add a task to the workflow using the REST API, and that'll place the task into a workflow. The workflow will take a look at the attributes in the task and decide which task queue to place it in. And then the task queue will look at its available worker and decide which worker will perform the task. Inside of the Twilio console, click on Task Router and then Get Started. And then we'll create a workspace. We'll call our workspace Customer Care Center, since it'll be a call center for our business. The next thing we'll do is create our first worker. We'll give our worker a name of Alice. Alice is going to have some attributes. She's going to have some languages that she speaks. And Alice is going to speak both English and Spanish, so she can serve incoming requests for both languages. We'll save Alice. And then we'll head out and create a second worker. We'll name our second worker Bob. Bob will also have a languages array, but Bob only speaks English. So let's save Bob and head to create our first task queue. Task queue will take a look at the workers and decide who can service a task based on their attributes. So we'll call this task queue Customer Care Request Spanish. This will service incoming calls that request Spanish language. The target worker's expression here will say languages has ES to specify that the language array for the worker needs to contain Spanish. We'll also create a task queue for English. So that'll be Customer Care Requests English, and this one will have languages has EN. If we click on task queues at this point, we can see our two task queues. And one of them has two matching workers, that's the English task queue, and the other one only has one, that's the Spanish task queue. That makes sense based on what we specified so far. Now let's create a workflow that'll handle incoming tasks and place them into task queues in a prioritized fashion. We'll call this incoming customer care requests. When an assignment's made, we'll have a callback URL. For now, we're just going to specify a temporary URL. We'll come back once we've implemented our callback in a moment. We'll set the timeout to 1200 seconds since we'll be handling this from the REST API and we don't want a timeout too early. Next, we're gonna create some filters. The first one is gonna be for language Spanish, and if a task has selected language equals ES, we're gonna put it into the Spanish task queue. Similarly, if the language expression matches selected language equals EN, we wanna place that into the English task queue for the customer care request. And then we're going to specify that the default should be none. We want everything to pass through a workspace filter to end up in a task queue. So that's it for our simple workflow mapping to English and Spanish. The only other thing is worker activities. We're going to keep the defaults offline, idle, busy, and reserved. We can toggle our worker through those different points during the application. One more thing we need in here before we start implementing some code, you're going to want to copy and paste the workspace ID and workflow ID so that we can take them into the configuration for our functions. So go to the Twilio runtime, go into functions, and click on configure. First thing you want to do is check off the box that says enable account SID and auth token so that it's easier for us to create a Twilio client from our code. Then here under environment variables, you're going to want to store the workspace SID and the workflow SID so that we have easy access to them in our Twilio functions using the context parameter for the function. Save that and we can head over to create our first Twilio function. Click on create a function and use the blank template to create your Twilio function. And we're going to call this one task assignment and give it a path of slash assignment. This is just going to be the assignment callback. For right now, we're not going to do much here. We'll just log out the reservation ID that gets passed in on the event, and then we'll call back with an empty object just to say, hey, we acknowledge that there was an assignment, but we don't want to do anything with it right now. We're going to use the REST API to handle that. We'll head back over to TaskRouter to our workspace, and you'll remember that there was an assignment callback URL. We need to take the URL from our function and copy that and paste it into the callback URL field and click save. That'll hook up the callback URL for our workflow. Save the function, head back to manage and we'll create another function. Use the blank template again, and this function is going to be the one that creates a task. We'll give it a path of /create-task, clear out the function that was there, and get to work. The first thing we're going to need is a Twilio client. So you can use context.getTwilioClient to make that super simple, since we already have the account SID and auth token from the configure page. Next, we'll use the client to create a task on TaskRouter. Client.taskRouter.v1.workspaces. Pass in the workspace SID from the context. Then we'll create a task on the tasks collection, passing in the workflow SID, also from context, the attributes. This time, we're just going to hard code this. This is going to be the selected language. We'll hard code it for now just to test it. We'll set the selected language here to Spanish to test that the workflow will place the task into the proper task queue for Spanish language. Once the task is created, we'll return from the function just simply some text to put out into the browser. It's going to say created task with ID. We'll save the function and copy the URL for the function and take it over to the web browser and test it out. This should create a task and render the text to the screen. If we head back to the tasks page, we'll see that the task was created and the IDs do match. We'll also see that it's placed into the Spanish task queue. That means our worker Alice should be able to work on it, but she's currently offline. So if we set her to idle, which makes her ready to receive tasks, she'll immediately go into the reserved state because she matches the task that's ready to be assigned to her. We see the reservation here and it's pending. So we need to accept the reservation to get it out of the pending status. Let's create a function to do that. We'll create another Twilio function using the blank template. And the first thing we'll do in here is we'll give it the name accept reservation and the path of accept. Then inside of our function, we'll create a Twilio REST client using the context parameter once again. And then this time we'll use TaskRouter not to create a task, but to reference an individual task's reservations. So first we pull up the workspace and then we reference the task that we just created. We'll pass in the ID for that. And then we want to access the specific reservation that Alice is waiting on right now. So if we take a look, there's that reservation ID for the pending reservation. Once we have the reservation, we can update it. And what we'll do is we'll set the reservation status to accepted. When this happens, Alice will be assigned the task. So let's log that out to the screen so that we know it happened successfully. When the promise completes, we'll use the reservation to return from the function and say that the worker for this reservation has accepted the reservation. We'll save the function, and then we'll copy the URL for the function and run it inside of the browser. We see that Alice has accepted the reservation. If we take a look at Alice, we'll actually see that she is now busy. To see another way to accept tasks, let's delete this task. And also, we want to set Alice back to offline. Now that our application is back to its initial state, we can see how to use an assignment instruction to automatically accept reservations. Inside of our assignment function, add an instruction to the empty object that says instruction accept. Save this out. Now, when an incoming reservation comes in, if there's a worker available to accept the reservation, it'll automatically accept the reservation without having to do anything from the REST API. We can test this out by running our create task function again, which will create a task. This time, when we go back to Alice and set her from offline to idle, we'll see that she goes straight to busy because the reservation will be automatically accepted. Taking a look at the actual task inside of tasks, we'll see that it's already been assigned to Alice. Now that we have a good understanding of how tasks and reservations work, let's create an IVR that allows the caller to press 1 to speak to a Spanish representative or 2 to speak to an English representative. We'll create a new function and we'll call it incoming customer call. And we'll set the path for the function to /incoming-call. Inside of this function, we'll use some TwiML, specifically a gather tag, to accept the digits from the caller. The number of digits that we'll be looking for is 1, and we'll set a timeout of 5 just to give them a little bit of time to press the digit. The action that'll run when we receive the digits is enqueue call. We're going to create a call queue to wait for a worker to be available to process the task. Inside of the gather tag, we're going to have a couple of say tags. Each one's going to request a given language. The first say tag will be in Spanish, and it will ask the caller to press 1 if they would like to speak to someone in Spanish. The second say tag, which will be spoken in English, will tell the caller to either hold on the line or press 1 to speak to an English-speaking representative. We'll save this function, copy the URL, and look at it in a browser just to make sure that it's returning everything correctly. It looks pretty good, so we're ready to move on. Let's buy a phone number. I'm going to look for one in the 215 area code. This is where our calls will come into. So when an incoming call is received, we want to run a function, and specifically the incoming customer call function. Save this out, and we can head back and create our next function. This is going to be starting from a blank function, and this is going to be the function that enqueues the call. So this was the one that we saw referenced in the gather tag. This is also going to return a bit of TwiML. This TwiML is going to enqueue a task to wait for an available worker. First thing we want to do here is grab the digits out of the event parameter, and we'll set the language to English since we said that they could hold on the line to speak English. If they did happen to press 1 though, we want to set the language to Spanish. Once we have a language, we're ready to use the enqueue task tag from TwiML, and that's going to reference a specific workflow SID, and we're going to create a task here. And what we want to specify here is that the selected language attribute for this task should be set to whatever language the user has selected on the call. Once we have that, we can save, and we can test this out in the browser by passing in the digits parameter. So we'll paste the URL in, we'll set the digits equal to 1, and we'll see that the selected language is Spanish. If we paste in and put digits equals 2, we'll see that English is selected. When we dequeue the task, we want to call the available worker. So we need to specify a contact URI for Alice so that when a Spanish call comes in, she can be called. So this is going to be just a phone number that Alice has that she will be called on. It just happens to be a Twilio number that I have that will represent Alice. Once we have her saved, we want to create an activity that she can go into when the call is completed so that she can wrap up and maybe take notes and that sort of thing before going on to the next call. Create that activity and copy the activity SID because we're going to need it here in the dequeue. The dequeue is going to happen inside of the assignment instruction. Instead of the accept that we had before, this time we want to do a dequeue instruction instead. This is going to take a few other things as well. One of them is going to be the post work activity SID, and that's going to be the activity SID for the wrap up task that we just created. So go ahead and paste that in here. And the last specified parameter here is the from phone number. That's going to be our call center phone number. This is the number that the worker will receive a call from when they have a task dequeued to them. So we'll save this, and we're ready to test by giving the phone number a call.
Para español oprime el uno.
For English, please hold or press 2.
When I press 1, the call is placed on hold, waiting for the worker. And we'll see that a task was created, and it's in the pending state. That's because the task is queued up. And if we take a look at Alice, we can see that she's offline. If we put her into the idle state, she'll immediately become available to receive the task, she'll go into busy, and she'll receive a call from the call center, connecting her to the caller. We've completed part 1 of the Customer Care Center using TaskRouter. In part 2, we'll take a look at how you can build a front-end web application that'll give you status updates on tasks and reservations, as well as allow you to update a worker's activity state. Stay tuned for that, it's coming soon. That's gonna do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, please click or tap the Twilio logo on the bottom left to subscribe so you know when we make more. If you wanna get the code, there's a button in the bottom right for that. And if you wanna watch another video, I picked one just for you. Until next time, I'm out of here.